Well, hello and welcome. I'm Kate and this is a Fountain Pen Awakening. And I am super excited for this. Oh my God, this like came in 2 days. So literally I ordered it 2 days ago and it's here. And I'm so excited. Why? Because after my last video where I was a bit underwhelmed, a bit disappointed with the Platinum Plaisir, I was feeling a bit sorry for myself. So I went on to Larry's post and I was kind of browsing through and they've got some amazing sales. And I came across this pen and I thought, oh my God, at this price, even if it's kind of not the color I really, really love, but it's got this nib on it that I have been wanting to try for so long. So I wasn't expecting it, so I'm going to jump on quickly and show you because I won't be able to wait till next week to film this. So without further ado, I will show you what this is. I am so excited. And I mean, look, at the end of the day, I know I've been going a bit cray-cray with my fountain pens, but for some reason, they're having amazing sales at the moment on certain websites. And lucky that I've got trusty Afterpay. So this is Larry Post in New South Wales. And they are just amazing with their, like if you spend over a certain amount, you know, you get free delivery and you get express posting, which means that it gets to me in 2 to 3 days. So it is a pilot, yes, but this is a real proper awesome pilot. So it comes in a clamshell box. Let me just pop all this over here. And yay! Da 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 da. This is a pilot custom 74 with a music nib. Yes, a music nib. I have been wanting to try one of these babies for forever and a day because I'm always whinging about the fact that these pens, you know, the pretty ones and the pretty colors here in Australia don't come with all the dib sizes. And you know, I didn't want to get a black pen because black is boring, but this is actually absolutely gorgeous. It's got a gold nib and it is a music nib. So what a music nib is, it's a stub nib. And I am so interested to try a stub nib. Oh my God, I'm so excited. I can't believe this came so quickly. And it's actually like a really beautiful looking pen too. Comes with the converter. Oh, this is like a Con 70 converter. Oh, that's interesting. And then it comes with a black cartridge. This is all the paperwork. I'm just gonna chuck that back in there, chuck that back in there, chuck that back in there. Oh, so excited for this pen. It's really lightweight too, to be honest. And what does it say here? Pilots made in Japan. So it's just a classic cigar shape, which I really like. I like this kind of domed effect, both on the bottom and the finial at the top. I like this ball clip. And it's just really classy. It's kind of really, sorry about the wobbles, it's actually really lightweight and fits super good in my hands. Oh, let me post it. Oh wow, it even feels good posted. It's not too back heavy or anything like that. Super nice. I'm so excited to try this music nib. You have no idea. And the price that it was at, I just could not, you know, not do it. I'm just going to do a quick size comparison with my Pilot Metropolitan and with my Sailor Progia and then Tisby. Get a Lamy out. Yeah, so like capped, it's exactly like a safari. and a little bit maybe smaller than my RS-25A if we uncap it. Oh, and it unscrews really fast too. Oh, everything's a rolling. Comparable or not. A little bit smaller than the Lamy. Yeah. Sorry, it's rolling because it doesn't have the cap. Yeah, a little bit smaller uncapped than the Lamy and the Twisby Diamond 580. Oh my goodness me. That is so, I'm so excited to try this out. And the price it was like phenomenal. You know, it was what? I think it was like over 100 and something discount on this. How beautiful is that? It's got pilot. I just love that kind of vintage look of it. And yeah, it's very similar to the pilot croc in better catch that in kind of style. But yeah, I got the gold trimmings because I just think that pops. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm just quickly going to ink that up and then just do a writing sample with you. What does it say? It says Pilot Matte MS, and that's the kind of feed there. It's like the plastic feed that they have kind of on. Okay. It's that same gray plasticky feed that they have on their other pens. It just shapes differently. But see, this one here is my calligraphy medium. And that's the stub. Let's see if you can see that. Can we see that? Yeah. Hey. That's actually the same. They're actually the same size uncapped. Don't roll. Oh, sorry. That's the little sword. Yeah, they are actually the actual same size uncapped. Interesting. Okay, let's do this. Now I just have to think about what ink I want to put in there. What ink do I want to put in here? Oh, I don't even know. Should I just do a dip test for now? And then I have to decide what ink to put in this baby. Okay. Let me go get sample ink. All right, so I've just inked her up with some Rhodonite from my Lamy Crystal Series. The thing is that with this Con 70, I don't know if it's working properly or not. It wasn't sucking up enough ink, so don't know what went wrong there, but anyway, we'll try it. Oh wow. Oh, it laid down heaps of ink. Pilot Custom 7-4. Oh, really nice. Some music nib. Oh, and you can really see the shading properties in the ink. This is a gold nib. I believe it's a 14 karat gold nib. And I've inked so not the smoothest of writing experiences, but I kind of like the look of the writing. Got a nib inked with Lamy Crystal. Wow, it does lay down heaps of ink. I didn't realize it would be so thick. It's kind of comparable to a Lamy 1.5 stub nib, I reckon. So fun. Interesting. Happy days. And this is Rhodonite. Wow. Yeah, I was kind of expecting it to be a thinner line for some reason, being a Japanese nib. But it gives me a bit of feedback, which I don't mind. Let's have a look if it goes small. Yeah, nice. Interesting. Very interesting, because it's a bit unexpected. I didn't realize it would be quite so wide. Oh, look, I'm super excited for this nib. I'm really glad I got it. And I mean, at the price that I purchased this pen, I couldn't go wrong. And I was so wanting to try, you know, like a Pilot Music nib, or even, you know, like a Sailor Music nib. I mean, the width of it and the feel of it when you're writing with it is kind of comparable to my Lamy 1.5, but I think this writes better and it's smoother. Now, I don't know what's wrong, but I just managed to get a little bit of ink in there and ink all over my fingers. But I think this thing is broken. Just, I don't know what's going on with that. But it wasn't sucking up anything. This cut, you press it and it should suck up, but I think this mechanism in here has come undone. So I might have to just get one of my M2 cartridges and just fill that one up. I don't know, they're giving me a broken converter. Wow. Thank you all for watching. And sorry about the wobbles. I'm just loving the shading with it. That's amazing. And this paper here is my Tomoe River paper in it.
I mean, I just wanted to show you. Can you see that shading? Like, how low? Look at that line variation. So cool. Absolutely. I can't stop myself. Loving it.
All right, there you have it. My new Pilot Custom 74 with a gold nib, but it's a music nib. Welcome to my collection. Thank you all for watching, for liking my content, for subscribing, and I'll see you in my next one. Dark like the shade.